Hello, 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 and welcome to all the Very Alley family. This will be a quick video where we are going to talk about the video game Destroy All Humans, a faithful remake of a cult classic game from 2005 with the same name. The game is developed by Black Forest Games and is being published by THQ Nordic, releasing on Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and Stadia on July 28th, 2020. It is a complete remake of the original Destroy All Humans from 2005. So basically, the visuals of the original Destroy All Humans from 2005 are being recreated in this 2020 remake. They have replaced piece by piece the older assets with new ones, including the art style, character designs, animations, and cutscenes. The main characters in this game are Cryptosporidium 136, the original Crypto clone, Cryptosporidium 137, our main character, Orthopox, Crypto's boss, Holopox, the hologram of Orthopox, Bert Wither, a radio broadcaster who sends out Furon propaganda. The remake of Destroy All Humans is really all about the original game, killing and destroying humans, their towns, the army bases, and disturbing the peace of mind of all the humans through various missions and objectives is the goal here. There are the major campaign missions along with some side missions. The gameplay is mainly action and combat oriented with some basic stealth elements thrown in as well. All these missions are faithful recreations of the original with only one new mission called Area 42 being added to this remake. Estimated total playtime is about 15 hours, including the side missions. The game is played from a third-person perspective. The player has control over Cryptosporidium 137. Crypto is an alien who makes it to our Earth in 1959 and takes place in the USA. The alien came to Earth to harvest human DNA. Creepy stuff, I know. The story is a fun take about what would happen if such a comical invasion actually took place, and the twist is that you play as the evil or villain alien this time, the invader, instead of the usual trope of playing as the hero or the defender. Crypto, our evil alien here, is armored with a large armory of really alien weapons such as the Zap-O-Matic and now infamous anal probe to effectively combat his human foes. Crypto also has some very distinguished skills such as paranormal powers and the power to camouflage himself as a human. Crypto can also use a jetpack to promptly maneuver the surroundings and can also control and fly the very capable flying saucer, which is armored with a death ray to kill off enemies. You can also perform special movements, such as gliding and dashing in this game and shoot opponents while lifting them. Moreover, you can also lock onto other enemies with a focus mode, newly introduced in this remake of Destroy All Humans. A shield can be used to protect Crypto from attacks, and it also informs the player about the attacks or about the directions of the attack. All that makes you kind of a powerhouse with a highly effective and destructive arsenal. Six main sandbox locations are in this video game. The player can also explore these locations freely. They all offer different challenges for the players and are the locations where the missions happen. The developer said, "We are not making a remake of the original game, we're making the remake of the memories players have of that game." The audio of the game is still the same, but it is modified and updated by the developers to make it better quality and more fitting for such a 15-year gap. Are you excited about this game? Have you played the original? Sound off in the comments below. Give the video a like if you liked it to support the channel. Also subscribe and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever new videos are uploaded. Thank you for watching and catch up with you in the next one. Bye-bye!